sailing on.
He's surfing on them, using them as a surfboard. I'll bet it, you know, sound like it'll work. Trust me, we're gonna have power, it's gonna work.
We're gonna have fun.
I'll be thinking of all kind of creative shit I'm gonna do. You be playing baseball with him, using him as a bat, just hold him by the legs, like, come on, I got it. Throw one of your babies hands at you. The women out here be looking harder than the men. The men are emasculated. Yeah, baby. No big joke, motherfucker. Just derping it up.
This is an entire prophecy once again. This is entire prophecy watch. I don't know who the fuck it is.
Some
Dabu 7. They actually go through it. They show you. Yeah. And you wonder why these bitches got all kind of demons under the shit, man.
Oh, so you talking about they put hurt and shit on the
beat. And that heathen hair is different than our hair. It has a different sign to it.
Hey, you don't know where that shit came from.
Right. I'm going to read some of this. Just a little bit of it.
What?
I missed something. That's called the fuck. Yeah, we see him coming.
Where did he get the confidence from? Well, I know what I was talking about. Satan. You feel me? No sense. People in the conversation, they're going to hide in the closet. He's scared.
Son became a faggot?
Oh, man.
Oh, my God.
Hey, literally, break your heart, man.
Make you want to commit suicide.
For real, man. Give up the ghost right then and there. For real. I'm going to read a little bit of this. Black bitches. How many sisters are here? Look at that shit, man.
Here, hold on. I got you.
Just when we was talking about the wind.
Hey. Prince of the power of the air, boy.
Yeah.
And they got Beelzebub out this motherfucker.
I'm gonna order a better tripod to have on the board. They can take some abuse.
I should just get like bungee cords or something. Fucking Satan. I just stuck mine in my book bag. Seems like that's where.
If I'm gonna go into labor any day, then why the hell are they not?
Oh, somebody really knocked it up.
See what I'm saying?
Man, these people in trouble when shit drop off, man. Like I said, woe to them that give something today.
Yeah, for real.
You know, they think they can depend on welfare all the time, man. Literally, man, that's what they depended on. She can't wait to get that first welfare check for them babies. She probably got other babies too.
Shit, man, that baby gonna come out weighing 1.5 pounds.
Right. I'm gonna eat the baby.
Yeah.
Gonna give me the baby for months.
I'm gonna have to give it some fucking, some methadone or something when it come out.
That's a curse coming into a world of dope. That's a fucking serious curse. How many sisters wear hair weaves sacrificed to idol God? How many sisters come to the church house with weaves sacrificed to idols? Let's explore the ramification of a sister in the church wearing a weave of human hair that was sacrificed to idol God.
Shit, if they going to that church, they talking about the church. First of all, the churches they in, that's nothing but idols up in there. The church itself is an idol.
That's right.
Go ahead.
I remember a couple years ago when my older sister was preaching, right in the middle of her sermon.
Oh, she was preaching. They going way off. Let's just deal with it.
The Holy Spirit told her to tell the sisters in the congregation to be careful where they get their hair wings from, because some of the human hair has been sacrificed to idols. About a week later, my sister's friend was watching an episode of National Geographic, in which they did a story about women in India who sacrificed their hair to idols. The sacrificed hair was then sold for profit. This was confirmation given by my sister. And India hair is a big export to the United States. And millions of dollars to the Hindu temples. The worshippers come to the temple to sacrifice their hair.
And them Hindus, they worship actual demons. I'm sorry. You look at motherfucking, what's that shit called? The Shiva. Goddamn eight arms or some shit. That's a goddamn demon, right? That's Krishna, right? That's a demon. Got blue skin. You fucking normal people have blue fucking skin. That's a goddamn demon. They worship the rat god, the monkey god.
Right. In 2016, we estimated roughly that 82 million of human hair from India exported to the United States, and that India is one of the richest exporters of human hair in the world. The hair is taken from the Indian temples, and shipped to factories in China. Just like they do with the music, they take it to the world.
Yeah. Because when they make music, they take the master copy that all the other copies are copied from, and they do a little seance, a little ritual, and they put demons on the record. Plus, the artists who make the fucking record, they're all Freemasons, you know what I'm saying? Church of Satan. That's just popular. And we ain't making that shit up. That's just common knowledge now. Everybody know about Jay-Z. That's old news. About how Jay-Z is selling Aleister Crowley shirts that say, "Do as thou wilt." Do as thou wilt. That comes out one of the most satanic books ever written. Aleister Crowley's Book of the Law. And that's the vibration that these hip-hop artists are pushing. Your boy Kanye West is rocking Baphomet shirts.
That's crazy.
Wearing Baphomet. You can't make that shit up. And everybody know the heavy metal. The heavy metal musicians, they've been worshiping Satan. Look at Slayer. Even though they claim they don't worship Satan. Of course, the devil worshiper is going to lie to you. Obviously. He's fucking worship Satan. That's what he does. Got upside down pentagrams on the house. Oh, they do open. Hey, your boy Dave Mustaine from Megadeth. One of the most famous heavy metal group. He claimed to be a Christian now, but he said back in the 80s, him and all the other musicians would take blood packs and dedicated themselves to Satan. They said they didn't know how you cut yourself. They would all cut themselves and maybe become blood brothers in Satan.
That's crazy. That's crazy.
He testified to that.
I heard Ronald Reagan started his own satanic church.
Oh, you know, it's well known that Ronald Reagan was into the occult. You know what I mean? They say he wouldn't start a speech until it was a certain time and the stars were aligned into the right spot. They said he did everything according to the numerology and the stars.
That's crazy. That's a long time.
And Ronald Reagan was wise in wickedness, man. That was an intelligent devil right there. You know what I'm saying? Boy, they love Ronald Reagan now too. Now they acting like Ronald Reagan is
demigod.
Yeah, it's a demigod. They deified that motherfucker. His retarded ass.
Big
Michigan.
I'll tell you, boy.
Because it's well built artist.
Because through the Spirit of the Lord, we out here exposing all this shit, man. You got brothers all over the country bringing this truth out, you know what I'm saying, lifting up this devil's skirt, lifting up the harlot's skirt.
That's right.
Because America's known as that great whore, so harlot. She committed great whoredoms, you know what I'm saying, throughout the earth.
What's discovering her secret parts?
Yeah. We
mercy.
We examining, you know, parabolically speaking, right, lifting up her skirt and we getting her secret parts. She got warts on that motherfucker. Gonorrhea, syphilis.
Right, pus.
Pus is oozing out of her secret parts.
Like these women. Like these women.
Yep. But that's just speaking of parables. You know what I'm saying?
Man, I can't wait to see them. Okay. The hair is taken from Indian temples and shipped to factories in China, where they are mixed with Chinese hair to form wigs and hair.
They're mixed with Chinese hair?
Yeah.
So you got some gook Hindu weaves up in your shit. What kind of crazy shit is that?
I don't get it. For the Western markets, the hair is being exported to saloon businesses in the U.S. and Britain. With these merchants, the big business, most prized long, silky hair.
They prize the long, silky hair.
Yeah. Hollywood is even affected by the Indian hair market. For the most part, hair that is sacrificed in the temple ends up as hair extensions for Hollywood actresses. The final cost is $3,000 per pop. And the, a lot of actresses get their black. A lot of black people get their black. That's 10 G's.
Damn.
It's called that black. They can keep it in long. I can actually say that shit is there for 10 fucking G's.
That's crazy.
10 G's.
Yeah, that's right. I see somebody trying to buy Beyonce's shoes.
Damn.
Used.
Ooh, that's a nigga for you.
That's like, she's like a saint to them. You know how they used to have the ancient relics of the fallen saints? You know, that's one of their saints.
It's crazy. The professional.
Because these motherfuckers is obsessed with celebrities out here. You know what I'm saying? America's obsessed. That's why TMZ is so popular. And that's one of the top news websites. TMZ. The motherfuckers are obsessed with celebrities out here. They care more about a celebrity's life than their own life. You know what I mean?
However, you also fuel revenue in the face.
That's what, yeah, that's the spirit you want to keep the pop shit on. Michael Jackson.
It also fuels revenue into these big Indian temples. Forget about it, twice you can build the financial gains of the market.
Yeah, that's
fucked
up, though.
But there's an actual video you can watch him doing it.
I didn't even know. I never knew that.
There's an actual video you can watch him do it.
Now, you tell these women that about where their weaves come from, you think they gonna stop wearing it?
Still.
Hell, they still going. They might go get an extra one.
Right.
They be like, ooh, I'm Chinese, baby. I always liked China. Oh, go ahead. If you would, could that make sense? You would take on their spirit, though. If you get, because you know, like witches and shit use hair for witchcraft, don't they? If they take a little bit of your hair, throw it in the potion and shit. That's why, when the old thing goes, when you, a woman to give you a lock of her hair so you can remember her by or something. You know what I mean? That has her spirit. That came out of her DNA. That's her DNA. You taking on someone else's DNA and shit and putting it on your head. Go ahead, what you got?
Okay, I'm going back to Matthew 27. Likewise, also the chief priest mocked him with the scribes and wrote his shit. He saved others. Himself he cannot save.
Right, they said he saved others. It ain't even witnessed it at that, too. You know what I mean? That's why he was so famous. But here it is. They talk this shit. That's how our people, man. They talk shit to the Lord himself.
Who that is? Who that is?
And we talked to him already.
I don't know, man.
We already talked to him, dude. I think he came up here talking shit. He was talking shit, like, bad one day. I think that was us. But he just, an old fool, like a clown, man. Here it is, 60 years old, man. Their life's still a fucking joke.
If he be the king of Israel, let him now come down from the cross, and we will believe him. If he trust in the Most High, let him deliver him now. If he will have him, for he said, I am the Son of the Most High.
And actually, that's the spirit, though. They said, if you the king of Israel, to bring yourself down the cross. But he told them, right? And they even repeated it. He said that they would, that the temple would be destroyed and it'd be raised up 3 days later. So he already told them that, he prophesied to them that he was going to be crucified. And they didn't even understand it or receive that saying.
Right.
Even the disciples didn't even understand.
The question.
They didn't even understand.
The question.
Oh, do you? So what happened to him is actually what he told him was gonna happen. So that's because the truth wasn't given off to everybody, man. Yeah, he speaks with parables. Yeah, Matthew 13.
Matthew 16. That time, again, to show unto the disciples that he must go into Jerusalem and suffer many things to the elders and the chief priests and scribes to be killed.
They raise up. They know what he's talking about. Go ahead.
And Peter took him in his hands and rebuked him, saying, "Be in far from the Lord, this shall not be what you do." But he turned and said unto Peter, "Get thee behind me, Satan, thou art an offense to me."
They called him Satan for saying that. The Lord's like, this gotta go down like this. You know what I mean? Go ahead.
Thou savior is not the things that be of God, but those that be of men.
Yeah, what's the things that be a man? The pride of life. Being afraid of death, you know what I'm saying? Shit like that. But he was in the spirit. I got a good scripture to a precept. But go ahead. I got a good precept for that.
You got a scripture there?
Yeah.
I was at 28% for a day. Oh, I'm never. But these also, which were crucified with him, cast the same in his teeth. Now from the sixth hour there was darkness over all the land until the ninth hour. And about the ninth hour Jehoshaphat cried with a loud voice saying, "Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani?"
Really, what he really said was Allah, Allah, which is God, God, God. It's not the Most High's name. He's saying, "Oh my God, oh my God." He's really saying Aliyah, which is my God, my God, my God. You know, he was quoting, what is that, Psalms, was that 22? He's quoting Psalms 22 and said, my God, why hast thou forsaken me? Go ahead. Because people be like, oh, if he was really, you know, with the Most High, how come he said, how come he questioned the Most High? You know what I mean? The people are simple. They don't know the scripture. And he's in the flesh. And it was already a scripture that was already written that prophesied what was happening.
That is to say, my power, why hast thou forsaken me?
Yeah, why hast thou forsaken me?
Some of them that stood there, when they heard that, they said, "This man called for a life." Wait, one of them ran to respond to
him. It was so stupid. They thought he was calling out for Elijah? How dumb is it? They didn't even know that what God was. I mean, how stupid are they? I tell you how stupid Israel is, man. Israel's some stupid assholes. Go ahead.
Straightway, one of them ran and took a sponge and filled it with vinegar and put it in a ring and gave him to drink. The rest said, let us see whether Elias will come to save him.
Let's see if Elijah will come to save him. That tells you they didn't, he said, he quoted, that means they didn't know the scriptures either. Because they would have known that was Psalms 22. And that's our people, they don't know the scriptures. But they come up and claim like they know everything. You know what I'm saying? Motherfuckers are scholars, experts on history.
Never even read a full book in the Bible.
Yeah, they don't know shit. The only kind of knowledge they got is what? They know the history of the ramp. They, you know what I'm saying? They know that history.
They know the Egyptians built the pyramids.
They don't even know that. They claim they know that. They don't even know that. That all they know, they can name you all the Super Bowls, maybe. They probably get that wrong. They know the BCS championship history, that's it. Or what is it, they have knowledge on foolishness, man. Go ahead.
All right, Hebrews 12. Wherefore, seeing we also are compassed about with so great a crowd of witnesses, let us lay aside every weight.
There's some Hindu here right there. That's it.
Ask her if you get some weed.
She's more Americanized.
Yeah.
Alright.
They ain't gonna talk.
They don't even acknowledge.
Yeah, they won't even acknowledge.
Yeah. Mobile's the same way, man. You try to talk to them, they don't.
Yeah,
unless
no,
they're
no,
Jake.
No.
Unless they're Jake.
Yeah, sometimes though, the mobiles you can yell them like, come here! Nobody's okay. Yeah, yell them like a dog. You know how you, if you yell at a dog loud enough, they'll come. They'll come. You know what I mean? Hey, go ahead.
It says, in the sin which doth so easily beset us, it is wrong with patience the race that is set before this point. Looking into Yahushua, the author and finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despising the shame, and is set down at the right hand of the throne of God. For consider him that endured such contradiction of sinners against himself, lest ye be wearied and faint in your mind.
Right, because you see what the Lord went through, man. You know, he was on the cross naked. Well, he had clothes, but they did strip him of his clothes, beating the shit out of him. He was humiliated. Right, because you know that he's probably, yeah, looking at his nakedness and all that. Making fun of him, talking shit to him, kicking him, spitting at him. They just tell you they spit on him. That ain't happening to none of us. Because you know, brothers, if you're thinking you got a bad or what, actually, I got a real good precept for that, man.
You have not resisted unto the flesh, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right, I got a good precept for that. Matthew 11 and 28. Come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for I am meek and lowly in heart, and you shall find rest unto your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. So here it is, the Lord went through all that crucified, put to death, humiliated, and he said his burden was light. You know what I'm saying? So. Oh, go ahead with it. Cause you know how you know brothers, they get caught up in the flesh, they can start getting weak and stuff. But you gotta think, is what is happening to you even as bad as what happened to the Lord or to the apostles? You know what I'm saying?
Here we go. How sharp when he had heard cried again with a loud voice yield up the ghost. And behold, the veil of the temple was rent in twain from the top to the bottom.
Yeah, the veil. And the temple was ripped in two. Now, if you know what the veil, there was this big giant curtain in the temple of the Lord, right? I mean, it's super thick. I mean, like gigantically, it's super heavy. If it fell on you, it'd probably kill you. That's how thick it was. And it ripped in two. Go ahead.
From the top to the bottom. And the earth did quake.
The earthquake.
And the rocks rent.
The rocks rent, meaning the earth split open. As the earthquake shit was going crazy, go ahead. And all the people was witnesses. The Romans seen it. The Israelites seen it. Why do you think this book is so popular? Because everybody witnessed that, man. That's how we know this is true. Go ahead.
And came out of the grave, and the graves were open.
Listen, the graves were open.
And many bodies of the saints which slept arose.
Many bodies of the saints. Wow.
Same thing with Lazarus.
Right. So a bunch of people rose about out their graves and started walking around. Walking around talking to people. You go, people were shitting themselves on that day. And they knew they fucked up. That would bug you out for real. Even, well, I don't know if it's in that account, maybe it's in the one in John. Even the Roman centurion or whatever, after he seen all that, he's like, oh shit, that was the Son of the Lord.
And
appeared unto many. So what you gonna do? You see people rise about their graves walking around. Accounts back, well, that was probably a little different than an actual zombie, though. Because the day was white, I'm sure. Did you ever hear, like, during the Black Plague, during the Black Death, they said people, the zombies and shit, would rise throughout the grave? Yeah, and it rose up. Yeah.
That's crazy, man. Now when the centurion and they that were with him watching the house on saw the earthquake and those things that were done, they feared greatly, saying, truly this was the Son.
They said, hey, that's
a turn. That is.
El Diablo.
Latin man.
I dig that.
Okay.
I agree. But like, yeah, like the truth goes deeper than that. Like that centurion, right there, he could have been an Israelite. Because who else would say, admit that that was the Son of the Most High? You know what I'm saying?
Many women were there before the she followed Yahweh Shah from that bitch to follow Yahweh
Shah. Nah, she was not no, she, hell, she said crucify him.
Right.
She was one of the people that, she was probably drunk too. Because she's spoken of blood. I'm talking about, I bring your ass down off there.
Right.
You got talking shit. Yeah. Probably throwing tomatoes at him. You know how these bitches be, bro.
Right.
Talking shit. The heckler. Haggler. What is it? Fucking
it's
demons. That's the spirit you talk about. Dependent and they just come out this cut.
And many women were there beholding far off the smaller girls like a gallery. Magdalene and Mary, the mother of James and Joseph, and mother of Zebedee's children. When the even was come, there came a rich man of Arimathea.
Yeah, Joseph, Joseph of Arimathea. I can't say it. Arimathea. Yeah, he was a rich man. He was an extremely wealthy man. You know what I'm saying? Go ahead.
Who also himself was